Hi, this is Ronald from Robo Biking. This video is about how to replace your bearings on a Hope Evo 2 hub set. So we're gonna do the rear wheel first. So let's remove the end caps on the left and right side. Sometimes they can be a little bit stuck, so you just have to pull harder to get them out. Okay, once you got them out, we now have to remove the freewheel. And that's done by just simply pulling it off the hub. You hear a slight popping noise, and that comes from the plastic washer. When you look in the hub, you see a washer. That washer is very important. It's on top of the bearing. We have to remove it and to store it in a very good place because we will need this one later. Okay, now let's remove the plastic sealing of the free hub. And when you have a close look at this sealing, you can see it has a round edge and a sharp edge, and you need to put it back in the same position as it came from. Okay, now we also are going to remove the poles and the springs. Just simply turn and twist them and they will be off. Them all being removed, we're now going to clean the free hub. This is the clean free hub. You can see the bearings inside and the spacers in between the bearings. Now I made this new bearing knockout tool with a countersink bolt in it, which has a lot of grip in it, and we also use the nylon hammer again. So you have to push the spacers in between the bearings a little bit to the left and the right in order to get a good grip on the bearing. But once the bearing is a little loose, you can knock it out very easily. So we first gonna do it. Start with the one on the side where there is a thread. This is the easy one. You can see the spacer that's in between the bearings. There are two spacers, a short one and a long one. And of course you need to put them back in the same order. So now the bearings are removed, so we are going to put in the new bearings. A new bearing, so I'm now measuring which the plastic tool I will need from the Boker bearing tool. I'm going to use the 25mm one. This will give me a good room to put the bearing in. So always use a little bit of lubricant when you apply new bearings. This will install them much easier, but also when you need to remove them, they will come out a lot easier. So now with the tool applied, just press in the new bearings. To align the tool so that it's properly aligned with the bearing, and just squeeze it in until you find a fuel resistance, and then you stop. So that bearing is in. Now we need the short spacer. Put that in there. Get the bearing. I already applied some lubricant. And now for this job, I had to make a special tool, special push in tool, because this one has to be applied very deep in the freewheel, and the spacers from the Boca bearing tool weren't long enough, so I made this myself. Same thing for this bearing, align the tool, gently squeeze it in, and stop when you feel resistance. So that one is in place also. Now we put in the long spacer, and this is a slightly bigger outer diameter bearing, so we need a new plastic press in tool. We're gonna need a 27 millimeter one, because the outer diameter is 28 millimeters. We have a little bit of tolerance on the outer edges. And you always use a spacer to press in the bearings. If you press on the outer cap of the bearing, that way you don't damage your bearing. So now that the free up is done, we're going to put in the springs and the poles again. So I'm here using a little bit of grease to make them work properly. First, put in the springs, and you can see it has a little bit of an opening, and that side is going to point upwards. So you just simply slide it in, and then turn it to the free up side, and then use it all the way around. So there are 4 springs and 4 poles. Put in the poles. You need to gently squeeze in the spring to give it the tension it needs. So I'm just using a small helpful tool to squeeze in the spring and pull down the pulley. Okay, now the poles are in. Now we have to put in the seal, and you have to put the seal in with the slanted side downwards, so pointing to the free up side, and this seal works just like a seal in a bearing. Very neat from Hope. So now we going to remove the axle from the rear hub. There are two bearings in the hub itself. So first of all, we need to knock out the axle and read it from the free hub side. So now it's removed. You see one bearing is in the hub, the other bearing is on the axle. And there are two small washers, and there's a sealant on the non-dry side. Keep them in a very safe location. So now we can first remove the bearing from the hub using this simple tool I made. Just the plastic bushing, the large one. So I don't damage my hubs. Here's the knockout tool I made. Simply knock the bearing all the way around, and it's out. So now it's removed and clean again. Then now installed in a new bearing. Of course, a little bit of a lubricant. Get the tool with the right spacers, and then gently squeeze it in. Of course, properly align the tool again. You don't want to press in the bearing in an angle, because you can then damage your hub. So make sure it's straight when you apply pressure. Okay, I knocked off the other bearing from the axle. Now I'm gonna put in the axle in the hub again with the spacers. Make sure it's completely in it, and now I'm going to press the bearing with the tool I made before. And I'm not going to use the bokeh bearing tool, but just simply tap it with my nylon hammer. And that worked best for this situation. So now it is in. Put it very nicely. Clean the seal as it goes on it. It's very important that you lubricate the seal in order that it doesn't dry out. Just simply squeeze it in. Now use a little bit of grease on the inner side of the hub. This is for the proper working of the free hub. Don't apply too much, because then the poles can stick to your hub and it doesn't work properly anymore. Now put in the spacer I talked about. The spacer is on top of the bearing, in between the pre-hub. And now you just simply push down the pre-hub. And we need to align the seal that is on the pre-hub. We'll pop in and now put in the end caps. So we're going to do the front wheel again. Front wheel is very easy. Just remove the end caps on the left and the right. Again, this these hope hubs are very well manufactured. There's a large spacer in between these bearings. So in order to knock these bearings out, you need to push the spacer a little bit to the left and the right. Otherwise you can't use the tool and you can't reach the bearings to knock them out. So it's very important to push the spacer a little bit to the left and the right when you're knocking out the bearing. So that's one side done. This is a spacer. It's a very simple. And now to knock out the bearing on the other side, which is now very easy to do with the spacer already removed. Again, all the way around, and not just knock on one side because that will damage your hub. Do this very gently. You really don't need a lot, of course. So now, let's use the correct spacer on the tool. Put in the bearing, of course lubricate it a little. Find the bearing tool. And just simply squeeze it in. Okay, now for the other side, put in the spacer, put in the bearing, and again use the same tool, spacers, and gently squeeze it in. So now that is done, you need to apply the end caps. Make sure the spacer is aligned properly with the bearings, and then the end caps are in. And then we're done with the front wheel. You can see here the spacer wasn't properly aligned, so I couldn't place the spacer very well. Okay, now the front wheel is done, so we have done both wheels with both bearings. Bye bye, till next video.